Hi Tango Dancer, would you like to learn an exciting circular movement to add in your dancing?
Tango follower, would you like to understand better the technique of the sacada and how to add it to your social dancing? If yes, this video is for you. We are going to show you how you can combine a sacada with an enrosqué, and you will see this is a movement that works really well on a lot of tango music.
Hi, we are Pablo and Anne from Tango Space,
where we help men and women to move better, express themselves, dance elegantly and meet friendly people with our tango lessons. In this video, we are going to break down a really exciting and beautiful movement that you can easily add to your social dancing. We are going to combine a sacada with an enrosqué, and you will see the movement for the follower is very exciting as well.
Yes, this movement is very, very exciting because we are going to add an enrosqué for the leaders and also create a different dynamic in the dance, and you can play much more adding sacadas in the heel as well.
If you are a follower, you will see this movement ends with a parada. If you love decorating in the parada, we have a special free guide for you. It's the free 5 decorations in the parada guide, where we give you 5 ideas that you can add whenever you want in the social dance, so you can decorate better, more, when your leader is offering a parada. So, we are showing you the movement first, then we will break down the steps, and then we will show you the movement with music.
Now we are going to break down the steps for the leaders. So we are going to show you now the practice embrace, and we begin with the apertura, with the side step together. I'm going to pivot her into the forward ocho, and now when she's going to the forward ocho, I'm going to collect my feet and change my weight. So now when I invite her to do the forward ocho around my axis, I'm going to go forward with my left leg to do a sacada. I want to take take out her free leg, in this case her back leg. So I go forward with my right leg. Leader, remember to create the space with the hips. Do not go pushing with the hips up. Drop the hips to create a space. So we do, when I do the first sacada, once I transfer my weight, I'm going to create the little enrosqué. Yeah? Since this is a decoration for the leaders. This is very important, leaders, to understand that we shouldn't interfere in what she's doing, yes? Her journey should continue in the same way. So she was doing the forward ocho. Now I'm going to add this decoration separate of what she's doing. So I'm going to bring my right leg forward and cross. So forward, cross, and I accelerate with my hips. So it's one moment. It's I go with my leg forward, I cross, and when I cross, I'm going to accelerate the hips facing the opposite direction, and that is the enrosqué. So again, so she's going forward, boom. I do the decoration, and now I continue with her journey. So now we are stopping for you to see, but the idea is that we continue with the energy flowing. So now she continues the giro. So I keep this position, she goes side, back, side, forward. So now I'm starting to pivot, following my partner, and I stretch my free leg, in this case my right leg, and I'm going to invite her to do a forward ocho. I cross behind, and now I do the second sacada, now with the left leg on this side, and then we resolve with the parada. This movement has very nice little elements that it's just a giro, but with the decoration of the enrosqué and the decoration of the cross after the second sacada, it adds a lot of nice elements in the dancing for the leaders.
Let's look at the steps for the followers. So we're starting with an apertura, so a side step. And then he's going to invite us to take a forward ocho. Here, don't forget, we really want to be connected with the center of the chest towards the leader. So open your shoulder blade, your left shoulder blade, to really bring the center of your chest towards your partner as much as possible. You take a forward step, And here, you don't let this happen. You use your core muscles to stay straight. This does require a little bit of work. Otherwise, if you let your body go, it's gonna go like this. Yes. We transfer our weights. He's going to pivot. At the same time we pivot, but we control our pivot so we can stay really stable and not make him fall. We take a side step, pivot, back, side, forward. These are the steps of the medio giro, so you should know them by heart. Again, we keep opening the shoulder blade, the left shoulder blade, to stay dissociated towards our partner. Yeah, forward step. And then here we have a parada, so we pivot, we cross the leg the way we want to, and then we resolve ending in front of him.
Now we're going to show you in the tandem embrace, and you will see how we use the flexibility of the embrace in this movement. So we begin in the close embrace, apertura, and now when I start pivoting here, I start releasing the embrace, so I start creating the space for myself to do the sacada, and now we're going to the sacada and the giro all in open embrace. So open, 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 and then parada, and then we resolve by closing the embrace again. So this flexibility adds a lot of power and dynamic in the giro. Yes, this idea of giving space, the giro, it feels more fluid, it feels with more energy, and you will feel more stable because you will be more in your axis if you open embrace.
So followers, you want to be always responsive. If your leader is releasing your embrace, you release it too. And at the end of the movement, you really want to go back into the close embrace. So looking for his center, looking for the contact with his chest. So let's show you one more time. Now let's look at the movement with tango music. Don't forget that if you want to have more ideas about how to decorate when you have a parada, how to look really elegant when you do so, we have a free special guide for you. We give you 5 special decorations that you can do with the parada. I will put the link on the comments below. It's free, so go ahead and download it and try them out.
Yes, and leaders, remember, we know it's challenging sometimes to add things in the giro, especially when you are leading the giro. But adding, you know, start adding, you know, some enrosques and some changes of weight as well is going to make your dance more interesting and more rich.
Yes, don't hesitate to take risks. So thank you so much for watching. We really hope this video is helpful. If this was helpful, if you like this video, please like it, give it a thumbs up, share it with the friend that you want to dance this movement with, and especially,
please keep learning and keep sharing your dancing, because the world of tango needs your embrace.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.
Bye.